Welcome, I'm Klaus Baltuschat, and today I will show you the latest modification of the UNEC 117, in particular Annex number 9. Hi Lars, nice to meet you.
Hi Klaus.
Are you preparing the skid trailer for a new test session?
Yes, I am checking if we are settled to do the wet braking tests according to the latest amendment of the UNECE regulation 117.
What are the fundamental changes of the new amendment of the regulation?
The most important change is that the tires are not only tested when new, but also in an artificially worn condition. This is to describe the behavior at the end of the use cycle. This is intended to give the consumers the certainty that they can safely use the tire until the legal tread limit of 1.6 millimeters in the European Union.
How does the artificial worn tires made?
The artificial worn tire is made by grinding down to a tread depth of 2 millimeters by the use of a special buffing and grinding machine. Also, the contour of the tire is defined. This is important that after the buffing, the footprint of the tire is not bigger than the one of the new tire.
Does the so-called SRTT tire, the standard reference tire, change as well?
You have to distinguish between the test in new condition and the test in worn condition. For the test in new condition, still the ASTM 16-inch specification 2493 is used. And for the test in the artificial worn condition, the same SRTT ASTM 2493 is used, but grinded down to a tread depth of 2 millimeters. You can understand one tire by using the so-called 2 euro coin test. I will show you. Place a 2 euro coin in the main grooves of the tire. If the outer silver ring is still visible, then the tire is worn out. In opposition, you can see with a tire that is new, if you put the 2 euro coin in the tread, the silver ring completely disappears. The grinded SRTT is used for a transitional provision. After that, a new SRTT tire will be used. This is the SRTT tire that is produced according to the new ASTM standard 36.11.22, and this is the so-called low tread depth SRTT.
Okay, if I compare the surfaces together, so the molded is different to the buffed one. Is the surface of the buffed one tolerated? And how do you measure the surface?
Yes, the surface roughness of the grinded tire must not be higher than the limit value of an average roughness profile RA, 20 micrometers.
Lars, thank you very much for your detailed information. Please go ahead with your preparation.
Yeah, welcome.
Would you like more information on R117? Then download our free white paper.